Winter tree ID. Identifying trees in winter is a little more tricky, so let's go through what to look out for and a few species that you might see. What to keep in mind for your ID? The location, bark, buds, nuts and seeds, and shape. You can also look for leaf litter as a clue, but this doesn't always work, so don't rely on it for a positive ID. The best way is to find a young, healthy branch. This will give you the best features for your ID. Just make sure you follow the right branch and not its neighbours. Looking closer at the buds, they will either be arranged alternating or in opposite pairs along the branch. Opposite is rarer, and there's only about 8 UK species that do this. The terminal bud is at the tip of the branch. If you see a cluster of buds here, then chances are you're looking at a cherry or an oak. Alder. Alder likes to keep their feet wet, so they're usually found around water or wetland. It's also not uncommon to see 2 or 3 trunks to a tree. Looking at their branches, alder has distinctive alternating purple buds. Alder has male and female flowers on the same tree that are both seen in winter. The male flowers, called catkins, are slender and purplish like their buds. The female flowers, called cones, start green and turn brown in winter. Alder is the only broadleaf tree that has these cones at seed. Ash. Ash is easy to identify once you know what to look for. Ash has jet black buds that run opposite along the branch, ending in a larger terminal bud. None of our other native trees has these. Young bark is smooth, flat, and greyish, which cracks as it matures, that can easily be mistaken for oak. Ash can be coppiced, so it is possible to see multiple stems on the same tree, otherwise grow tall, around 40 metres, and is fairly straight if left by humans. You can see their seeds growing in big bunches, called keys, that are bright green in autumn, that fade to brown, that are very visible in winter as the leaves fall around them. In late winter, you can see the wispy stems that held the keys after the seeds themselves have blown off. This is one of the trees that looking for leaf litter will not help you, as ash trees are one of the first to lose their leaves, and they quickly degrade. But you might see the seeds that have fallen around them at the base of the tree. In their silhouettes, you can see 3 prongs made by their branches that look like pitchforks or bird's feet. Birch. There are 2 species of birch in the UK, silver and downy, but since they can hybridise, it's not always easy to tell them apart. Birch are pioneer species, so are one of the first species that will move into an open area to create open woodland. If left uncut, they will usually grow on a single, slender trunk. Young birch bark has more of a golden brown, but this goes to a papery off-white colour. Birch naturally shed their outer layer of their bark, which you can sometimes see peeling off. Both male and female flowers can be seen on the same tree. The male catkins will appear well before the females, with the males appearing in autumn that hang down and waiting for the females to arrive in April that grow upwards. Birch has alternating buds with no terminal bud. But since the other features are so distinctive, we don't need to look any closer. Hazel. Commonly seen growing as hedgerows, hazel trees can grow around 12 metres tall. Hazel likes to self-coppice, so will send up new stems, called rods, from its base throughout its life. If coppiced, hazel can live up to several hundred years. Young bark can be darker brown than the mature greyer bark, which is covered with yellow-white speckles called lenticles, which are breathing pores. You can sometimes see their branches zigzag with their alternating oval buds that vary in colour from green to red. Look closer and you can see hairs along their stems. Hazel has both male and female flowers on the same tree, with little red anemone-like female flowers, and the more noticeable yellowy-green male catkins that you can see from afar, giving the trees a yellow glow. Below the tree, you might see their fallen oval leaves that end at a pointed tip, or even the husks of the hazelnuts. These ones were most likely eaten by mice, as squirrels would split the nuts in half. Holly. Hollies are only broadleaf evergreen in Scotland, so since they're green all year round, we don't need to look further than their leaves. Holly has dark green waxy leaves that start spiky, but smooth going up the tree. Look out for their bright red berries, but only the female trees will have them, which is why we'll see them on some and not others. Oak. Look for a cluster of buds at the branch terminal. Both species of oak in the UK have visible scales on their buds. Oak leaves are rich in tannins, so take a while to degrade, so it's not uncommon to see leaves still attached to the tree or spread underneath. Rowan. In Greek mythology, Rowan took its shape from a battle between an eagle and a demon. As they fought, blood and feathers fell to earth, and in its place stood a rowan tree. One of these features we can see in winter, and they're deep red berries that are a great food source for birds. And later in the spring, with their serrated feather-like leaves. Rowan has silvery grey bark, but your best indication if you can't see any berries are the buds, which are alternating and hairy.